Thank you. Do you ever feel like breaking down? Do you ever feel out of place? Like somehow you just don't belong and no one understands you? Do you ever want to run away? Do you lock yourself in your room with the radio on turned up so loud that no one hears you screaming? No, you don't know what it's like when nothing feels alright.
It was the best of times, it was the worst of times. It was a wasted generation. It was a youth-led segregation. Lives are labeled early on, a puzzle piece, a willing pawn. The puppet master stirred the pot while social conscience began to rot. So watch along as we recreate your generation's self-inflicted fate.
It's not easy being a popular trendsetter. Everyone's always watching you. Everyone wants to be you. And I mean, there's always all that added pressure to be always in the know on what's going on. I mean, you have to have the right hair, the right looks, the right clothes, the right body. But don't get me wrong, high school's a really sweet time. I love flirting with the eye candy, watching all the football players, and hanging out with my friends. And, but then again, just like any other teenager, I love hearing the latest rumor. And I like to add my own two cents in. What's the harm?
Let's get one thing straight. Did you ever see the movie Cruel Intentions? I compare myself to the Sarah Michelle Gellar character. So I'm an instigator, big deal. I get pleasure out of other people's pain. I revel in the universal suffering of others.
I always despised school. I felt like the classes were redundant and boring. And the thing I hated the most, though, were the people. The posers, the jocks, the preps, they all thought the school was theirs. What a joke. I mean, in 10 years, who's gonna care who the valedictorian was, or who prom king and queen were, or who the football players were? No one will, that's who.
Okay, what's so wrong with being smart? Why is that when you get good grades, you're automatically isolated from the so-called in-group, whatever that means? And whoever decided who was ever gonna be a cool kid or an outcast? What was it based on? Social status? Looks, athletics. Well, I come from a poor family. And hey, I get good grades. And I can't tell a touchdown from a home run, but hey, I'm still an interesting person. The funny thing is that no one really knows who I really am. My likes, my dislikes, my joys, my fears. In reality, I'm a fun person to be around. If only they get past my exterior.
You know, it really annoys me when people automatically assume that just because you're the quarterback, that your parents are rich, or you're attractive, or you're related to some random football star, that life would be just perfect. Yeah, right. My dad's a doctor, and he expects me to go to Duke for my master's in doctoring, just because he did. And, you know, of course, play football. And, you know, I don't even want to play football or be a doctor. I want to be an actor. It's not like anyone's ever asked.
Chance is so fine.
The letting go of anger has three stages. The first stage is allowing the anger to build. The anger consumes you till you are left with a rage you can no longer control. The second step is the releasing of the anger. How the anger is released varies, but there is always a victim who receives the full extent of the wrath. It might be a parent, a girlfriend, a wall, your own body, but it must be released on something for it to occur. The third stage is regret.
Have you ever been so angry that you just snap? All you want to do is cry, but the tears never come. That's how I feel all the time. I have cried and cried until I have no mere tears left. I have punched until my hands have bled. I have yelled and screamed every profanity I know, yet I never feel better. Every day, I hate myself and my life more and more.
So, I was always perceived as the shy one because I didn't talk much. I suppose in some ways that was true, but only because I tended to only talk when I had something intelligent to say. But in my senior year of high school, I wanted to be a part of something and break out of my shell. Ethan did that for me.
Tamara was an amazing girl.
I knew I had to get to know her. I knew underneath that shy exterior was a beautiful, sweet girl way deeper than the average girl. But high school is what you made of it, right? You could be the center of attention in the mix of everything, or you could be on the sidelines looking in. I chose the happy medium. And although as much as I tried not to fall into the cliques of high school, I did.
Did you ever start a rumor and watch it grow? It really is a magnificent piece of work. One simple lie and the web is wove. There are very exact tips to the art of gossip. One, the more outrageous the lie, the more believable it is. Two, the more innocent the target, the more eagerly others believe. And three, never ever let the truth come out. The perfect lie eventually becomes true. Spreading and spreading.
Tamara broke up with me, and at the end of the semester, transferred to another school.
So time went on, and another rumor started about someone else, and this one faded quickly from memory. Two people's lives changed forever, and me? Amused. I am the puppet master.
It was the best of times, it was the worst of times. It was a time of perseverance where everything was based on appearance. Lives were shattered, tainted forever, all for the sinister pleasure of the puppet master who set the fire and watched the flames with higher. So she smiled, laughed, gave the evil grin as she bathed in the glory of her sin.
Now take it. Part of the furniture, there is counting, I'm counting on you. Here's who I am. I'm counting on you.
Here's where I stand.
Here's where I stand.
Here's where I am. Mic check. All right. Let's do warming up. Let me get some water.
Ruler, you can call me Queen Bee, and baby, I'll rule. monkeys jumping on the bed. Five little monkeys jumping on the bed. Five little monkeys jumping on the bed. Five little monkeys jumping on the bed.
Look at them jump, look at them jump, look at the monkey jump. I said, look at the monkey jump. Look at them jump, look at them jump, look at the monkey jump. You naughty little monkey. Look at them jump, look at them jump, look at the monkey jump. Look at the monkey jump. Look at them jump, look at them jump, look at the monkey jump.
Jumping on the bed. One fell off and bumped his head. My mama called the doctor and the doctor said,
no more monkeys jumping on the bed.
Four little monkeys jumping on the bed. One fell off and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said,
no more monkeys jumping on the bed.
Yeah, look at the monkey jump.
Look at him jump, look at him jump, look at the monkey jump.
You naughty little monkey.
Look at him jump, look at him jump, look at the monkey jump.
Yeah, jump. Look at the monkey jump.
Look at him jump, look at him jump, look at the monkey jump.
Three little monkeys jumping on the bed. One fell off and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said,
no more monkeys jumping on the bed.
Jumping on the bed. One fell off and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said,
no more monkeys jumping on the bed.
Break it down. You are a naughty,
naughty, a naughty little monkey.
You are a naughty little monkey for sure. You are a naughty,
naughty, a naughty little jump, monkey.
Jump, jump. Don't feel bad, you bumped your head on the floor.
Your head on the floor. One little monkey jumping on the bed. He fell off and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said,
no more monkeys jumping on the bed.
Come on.
Look at him jump, look at him jump, look at the monkey jump.
Jump,
look at the monkey jump. Look at him jump, look at him jump, look at the monkey jump.
You naughty little monkey.
Look at him jump, look at him jump, look at the monkey jump.
Jump, look at the monkey jump.
Listen to your mama.
Look at him jump, look at him jump, look at the monkey jump.
We'll be right back. Something has changed within me. Something is not the same. I'm through with playing by the rules of someone else's game. Too late for second guessing. Too late to go back to sleep. It's time to trust my instincts, close my eyes, and leave.
It's time to
my
see a brand new you.
Policy, a sonata, or a mechanical computer.
Creativity is a spark. It can be intensely satisfying when the flame catches and a new idea sweeps around the world.
I'm not afraid to
idea of flow from the human spirit is absolutely unlimited. All you have to do is tap into that well. It's creativity. To do anything truly worth doing, I was not stand back shivering and thinking of the cold and danger, but jump in with gusto and scramble through as well as I can.
Ba, 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 da, 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 ba, ba.
And that is the finale for this evening. On behalf of everybody here with the performers, how about a nice round of applause for all of our performers this evening, from elementary school to middle school, all the way up to high school. Thank you for being here. Thank you for supporting the arts in Brunswick County Schools. Good night, everybody.